For Chelsea's birthday, I took her on a 10-mile float trip down the Buffalo National River.
There you go. Good job.
We had the river to ourselves. Everything was serene. Until we reached Hendon Hollow.
We gotta paddle. Just keep paddling and have control of your boat and you'll be alright. Woo! Don't tip! Hey, yeller!
Looks like we lost the paddler. Chelsea lost it back there a little ways.
Chelsea and I are headed down to Kyle's Landing on the Buffalo National River. Located in northwest Arkansas, the Buffalo is America's first national river, running 153 miles from the Boston Mountains in the Ozarks east to the Salem Plateau, where it joins the White River. The Buffalo has been protected by Congress since 1972 and is managed by the National Park Service. We're paddling the upper section of the Buffalo from Ponca, 10 miles downstream to Kyle's Landing. Our day started out at our cabin, which was located on the Boone and Newton County line, about 3 miles from Irby. After dropping off our pickup vehicle at Kyle's Landing, we made our way back to the Ponca Water Bridge and got started. In March, the river can be bony, but this year we got some good rainfall and river levels were high.
Say hi. Okay, go down past this bluff. Past this bluff. All right, well, if you want to pull over there, go for it.
Here, we're coming up on the first major bluff on the river. There's no name for it that I know of. Nothing on the topo maps from National Geographic. But it's still impressive, and they only get better. Three miles downstream, we reach my favorite bluff on the river.
Why don't you go first? That way I can watch you.
At 200 feet tall and nearly a mile long, Rourke Bluff is an iconic landscape along the Buffalo, providing a gorgeous backdrop for the campsite at Steel Creek, which we're about to run into.
I want to have mounts on both. You just mount them on the front. Whatever he wants, I'll ask him.
That? I mean, I got two. That's your one.
Right. On the upper buffalo, for sure. No, no. Yeah. Been a turtle. I think that was a turtle. Yep. Woo-hoo. That's pretty though, out there. That's pretty, I love it.
I'm not sure that I could go up much higher. Really.
If you could what?
Just would want to go much higher.
Yeah. This is where I need to get a picture, right?
It's not much.
Yeah. Roark? Roark. No. You can. You mean from the Seal Creek put in? Yeah. 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 Okay, so you want to kind of stay to the left here. Remember, to the right, there's a big old rock. Nope, well, don't go right. Well, you got to paddle. Just keep paddling and have control of your boat and you'll be all right. No, it's too bony over there. If the river was higher, yeah, but... Oh, you're good. This is easy right now. You can just follow the main channel. The main current. Oh, I see it now, yeah. Oh, you'll be all right. Just paddle. There you go. Good job. Good job. Woo! Yeah. Well, it looks pretty bony through here too. Back on my knees. Yep. Gnarly. Good job. Hands are cold? Yeah. What? Oh. Hey, right here, remember when we came here with Nikki and Jacob? Right here is where those kids got, remember they turned over, we had to rescue them? Jacob and I did, right here.
Probably right back
there. Alright.
No.
You did?
He's right down to the side.
Well, you need the water gun or what?
No, I don't need that.
Oh. I gotta pump some water out a little bit. I'm gonna do it right now. Not much.
Now we're coming up on Big Bluff, the tallest bluff on the river.
Here's Big Bluff. Huh? Yep.
It's 550 feet tall, making it the tallest cliff between the Rockies and the Appalachians.
Right. That was our first hiking trip. Our first hike.
There's also a hike near the top of it, the infamous Goat Trail, which I think offers the most gorgeous views in the entire state.
What? Oh yeah. Oh yeah, I can see him. Sure. It's the first time I've seen people on the trail, actually. Yeah. Huh. don't remember it being so wide and slow through here in the past, right by Big Bluff. Could be wrong. Oh man, look how shallow. River's pretty low. That's still good. Jim's Bluff. This is where you're supposed to smoke a joint. Drink half a bottle of whiskey and jump off this rock naked.
Right here it is.
All in the name of
Mr. Mojo Rice.
Duckies. Yeah. You're lighter. You're lighter. Lighter.
Yeah, I don't remember it being
fast. You don't remember what?
I don't really remember it being fast.
Yeah. What are you doing? Oh, that's not good. All right, so paddle hard. Paddle hard. And you're gonna kind of be curving. Stay in control, keep paddling. Yeah. Yes. Yes. Yes, you got it. Don't tip. Yeah, you gotta learn how to paddle that, babe. Holy cow. Hey, I gotta give you some paddling tips, babe.
Now we're approaching the trailhead to Hemden Hollow.
Perfect. You can make it. Dirt. Don't let it. Oh yeah. It just says trail.
It says fall.
Just ditch your paddle, just throw it out. What's the matter?
The hike is short and picturesque, with a few smaller waterfalls along the way. At 209 feet, Hemden Hollow Falls is the tallest waterfall between the Appalachians and the Rockies.
All right, let's get closer. Well, at least it's biodegradable.
Here, Chelsea's passing the ruins of an old building. Throughout the Buffalo River watershed, there are many old cabins and homesteads, many of which are protected by the Park and Forest Services. Now we're coming up on Hell's Half Acre in Gray Rock.
Okay.
Paddle, paddle, paddle. Paddle, paddle, paddle.
Well, looks like we lost the paddler. Chelsea lost it back there a little ways. I had to tow her in.
See that little blue over there? Ah, yeah, that's her.
Well, that's what the river's for. If you don't get wet, you're not having fun. There's also this old saying about the river. If you and your wife can survive it, then y'all can survive anything. Until the next time, happy trails.